Hi children, how are you all? Fine, hope you're all doing good, right? Great. So, let's start our session today. Before that, shall we start this session with the prayer, children? Right? Okay then. So, close your eyes, join your hands, and listen to me, what I'm saying, right? So, stay calm, be relaxed. Fine. Listen to me, children. Asatoma satgamaya tamasoma jyotirgamaya mrityoma amritamgamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Great children, are you feeling fresh now? Very good. Now slowly open your eyes. Thank you. So children, so in this session we are going to recall our topics from previous sessions. What we discussed about this topic in the previous sessions, just we are going to recall that. So till now what we saw, we saw about digestive system. So what are the new words we learn in this lesson? We learnt about salivary gland, digestion, esophagus, small intestine, large intestine. These are the new words we learn about. So what is salivary gland? It is a gland that produces saliva. Then what is digestion? It is the process by which the food gets broken down into simple form in order to produce energy. Then esophagus, it is nothing but the food pipe through which the food will be sent to stomach. It is a long muscular tube. Then coming to small intestine and large intestine. Small intestine is a long narrow coiled tube which helps in absorbing the nutrients of our food and in the process of digestion. Okay, whereas long intestine reabsorbs the water in the food and the solid waste will be sent as feces through anus. Okay children, so next what are the topics we discussed? We discussed about digestion, organs for digestion, then those organs: mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, liver and pancreas. These were the topic we discussed in this chapter, right? Shall we recall once again? So what are the organs? The organs are mouth, food pipe or esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, liver and pancreas. Okay, with the help of mouth, we cut and chew the food very properly, and then with the help of saliva, the food will get soft and wet so that we can swallow easily. The food pipe is a long muscular tube which sends the food downwards to the stomach. It is also known as esophagus. Okay, the stomach is a large sac-like organ which contains digestive juice. With the help of the digestive juice, the food will digested into a thick paste. Then the food will be sent to small intestine. In small intestine, the food will further digested with the help of digestive juices from liver and pancreas, and the nutrients from the food will be absorbed here. The remaining undigested food will be sent to large intestine. In large intestine, the water will be reabsorbed and the solid waste will be sent as feces through anus. This is what happening in our digestive system. In this, liver and pancreas play a vital role. Liver filters the harmful substance from our blood and produce bile juice, whereas pancreas produce pancreatic juice which helps in the digestion of carbohydrates, fats and proteins. Then we saw about tips for healthy digestion, right? How the digestion will be healthy, or how will make the digestion process in a very easy manner, right? So what are the measures we have to follow for making the digestion very easily? So what are the tips, children? We have to eat our food at regular intervals of time. Then we should eat slowly and chew the food properly. Then we should eat variety of food such as fruits, green vegetables, cereals, pulses, etc. Then we have to drink more water. That is, we have to take lot of fluids. Okay, we have to take lot of fluids like water, juices, which helps the digestion process. Okay, then we have to avoid eating of excessive junk food. Okay, these are the tips that makes our digestion easily and proper and more properly. Okay, so children, in this session now we are going to see about some of your questions in the workbook. So let's see. Okay, now let's start with the first question. It is true or false statements, right? So the first statement is, most of the food which we cannot be absorbed, which we eat, cannot be absorbed by our body directly. Once again, I'm repeating, most of the food which we eat cannot be absorbed by our body directly. Is it true, children, or false? That most of our food we are eating will not be absorbed by our body. Is it so? No, it is a false statement. Oh, so you have to write it as false. Okay, so coming to next question, our body absorbs all the food we eat. No, the remaining undigested will be sent as solid waste. So the statement is false. Next statement, we should not eat different types of food. This is also false, because we have to eat variety of fruits such as fruits, vegetables, etc. Right? Then chewing the food properly helps in mixing of food with saliva and this improves digestion. Yes. So the statement is true. Next, coming to match the following, mouth. What it is used for? It is used to cut. Here food is cut, chewed and mixed with saliva. Okay, then about salivary glands, what it is used for? It helps in the process of digestion by producing saliva. Next, esophagus, a long muscular tube that helps the food to reach from the mouth to the stomach. Then stomach, what is the purpose of stomach? It is a sac-like organ in which food breaks down. Next, small intestine, this is a narrow coiled organ that helps in absorption of nutrients from food. Next, large intestine, organ that helps in reabsorption of water from the undigested food. Okay, children, so now we are going to discuss about the homework of previous session. What I gave the homework for previous session, you have to choose the correct answer, right? Shall we discuss about that? Okay, let's. So the first question is, the breakdown of food molecules into smaller components that can be absorbed and used by our body is called. What is the process called, children? It is a process by which the food particles get broken down into smaller particles. That process is called digestion. Very good. So the answer is digestion. Coming to the second question, dash is the organ system that comprises the mouth, food pipe, stomach, small intestine and large intestine. The organ system are digestive system, respiratory system, circulatory system. Among these systems, which has these organs, mouth, food pipe and all? Yeah, digestive system. So the answer is digestive system. Okay, so coming to the next question. The cutting and chewing of food is done by which part do this work? Yes, teeth. The cutting and chewing of food is done by teeth. Very good. Next question. Dash helps in tasting and pushing the food downwards into the food pipe. Which organ, children, that helps or has to push the food downwards? Is it teeth, salivary gland, or tongue? Yes, it is tongue. Very good. So coming to next question. The long muscular tubes that runs from the mouth to the stomach is called, what is its name? Yes, esophagus. Very good. Next question. The esophagus is also called, it is also called food pipe. Super. So coming to next question. Digestive juices from liver and pancreas mixed with the food in which organ the digestive juices, these digestive juices get mixed with the food? Very good. It will get digested with the food in small intestine. So the answer is small intestine. Super, children. So the next question is, water is absorbed from the undigested food in which organ? Right, large intestine. Next, dash acts as a filter for harmful substances in the blood. Which organ filters the harmful substance? Right, it is liver. So the answer is liver. Then coming to the last question, anus helps in removing dash in the form of feces from the body. For what anus is present? It helps to remove the solid waste. Very good. So the answer is waste. Nice. So very good, children. So you finished your homework in a good manner. Very good. Applause to everyone. So children, for this session, the homework is as follows. So browse the net for finding about diseases related to human digestive system. Any two diseases that are related to human digestive system. Okay, once again I am repeating, browse the net about any two diseases that are related to digestive system. Okay, you have to mention their causes and symptoms. Okay, children. So I'll post the homework in the classroom app. You have to finish that and repost it. Okay, children. Till then, stay connected, stay safe, and keep learning. Okay, bye.